وقال خصيف المجاهد أنه قال فواتح السور كلها قاف وصاد وحميم وتواصيم وألف لام وغير ذلك حجاء موضوع. No, خصيف such from مجاهد. He records from مجاهد. Watch. All these letters are certain Arabic letters. This in the beginning of surahs. Some letters of the alphabets. Only that much. Then, فقال بعض أهل العربية هي حروف من حروف المعجم استغني بذكر ما ذكر منها في أوائل السور عن ذكر بواقيها التي هي تتمة الثمانية والعشرين حرفا كما يقول القائل ابني يكتب في ألف باء تاء ثاء أي في حروف المعجم الثمانية والعشرين فيستغنى بذكر بعضها عن مجموعها حكاه ابن جرير. That is, some linguists said that, Arabic scholars said that, هي حروف من حروف المعجم. Those letters are some of the Arabic letters. استغنى بذكر ما ذكر منها في أوائل السور. عن ذكر بواقيها. That is, those letters are used to represent all the letters. This, some letters are used, but those letters are used to represent the whole letters. Here, actually, 14 letters are there, used in this way, in the beginning of chapters, beginning of surahs, 14 letters are there. All together, how many letters are there in Arabic alphabet? 28. Okay, 28 letters are there. So, 14 letters are used. Those 14 letters used to represent other letters too. Just like we say, Ibni yaktubu fi alifba ta tha. My son writes or learns alifba ta tha. Or my son learns ABCD. Means my son learns A to Z. The whole alphabet. Alifba, my son reads. Alifba ta tha means my son reads Alif ba ta tha only, not that much. Alif ba ta tha up to ya. Okay, the whole letters. Just like that, here some letters are used and it represents the whole letters. Okay, then. And with those letters, the whole Quran is made. Okay, the whole Quran out of these 28 letters. Okay. Now, post 3, you see. قلت مجموع الحروف المذكورة في أوائل السور بحذف المكرر منها 14 حرفا وهي ألف لام ميم صاد راء كاف ياء عين طاء سين حاء قاف نون. So قلت I say means this is تفسير ابن كثير. So إمام ابن كثير say it is مجموع الحروف المذكورة those mentioned letters all together, في أوائل السور, in the beginning of the chapters, surahs, بحرف المكرر, deleting the repetition, or avoiding, or removing the repetition, منها 14 حرفا. There are 14 letters. So, avoiding repetition, if we take the individual letters, which came in the beginning of certain surahs of Holy Quran, then we get how many letters? 14 letters are there. How many letters are there? 14 letters in the beginning of 29 surahs. 29 surahs. So, there Alif, Lam, Mim, Swad, Ral, Kaf, Yal, Ain, Fa, Sin, Ha, Kaf, Noon. All this. Yajma'uha qawrika nasun hakeemun qati'un lahu sirrun. Your sentence like this. Nasun hakeemun qati'un lahu sirrun. This sentence will combine all these letters. If you remember this sentence, نَسْفٌ حَكِيمٌ قَاطِعٌ لَهُ سِرٌّ. If you remember that sentence, then all the 14 letters come under this sentence. Okay. Alif, Lam, Mim, Swaf, Ra, all this come under this sentence. وَهِيَ نِسْفُ الْحُرُوفِ عَدَدًا. So, all together 28 letters are there. So, these come 14. So, نِسْفُ الْحُرُوفِ عَدَدًا. عَدَدًا in number. So, in number, there are 14 letters here mentioned in the beginning of the surah, individual letters. وَالْمَذْكُورُ مِنْهَا أَشْرَفُ مِنَ الْمَطْرُوبِ. So, those mentioned letters in the beginning of surah are nobler than those avoided letters. So, some letters are avoided and some letters are considered. So, those letters considered by Allah as individual letters in the beginning of some surahs are nobler than those letters which are avoided by Allah. Okay. No. وَمِنْ هَهُنَا لَحَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ فِي هَذَا الْمَقْطَارِ كَلَامِ. No certain scholar said that. فَقَالَ لَا شَكَّ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْحُرُوفَ لَمْ يُنْزِلْهَا سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَبَثًا وَلَا سُدًى. لَا شَكَّ. There is no doubt at all. أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْحُرُوفَ. Certainly these letters are لَمْ يُنْزِلْهَا. These letters لَمْ يُنْزِلْهَا سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't reveal these letters عَبَثًا وَلَا سُدًى. For just and play. Not for just and play. Not merely, not simply Allah revealed these letters. We don't know the exact meaning. That doesn't mean these letters are revealed by Allah simply or out of just and play. We can't say like that. Okay. There is meaning. But we can't know. Sometimes we don't know only that much. But there is plan behind all actions of Allah. Okay. All actions of Allah. Okay. Now. وَمَنْ قَالَ مِنَ الْجَحْلَةِ إِنَّهُ فِي الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ تَعَبُّدٌ لَا مَعْنَى لَهُ بِالْكُلِّيَّةِ فَقَدْ أَخْطَأَ خَطَأً كَثِيرًا. And those people who said that these individual letters are some letters which have no particular meaning at all, those people are actually ignorant. Ibn Kathir say, those people are actually ignorant and they are wrong. They are. Their argument is wrong, actually. Then, فَتَّعَيَّنَ أَنَّ لَهَا مَعْنَى فِي نَفْسِ الْأَمْرِ. And actually, those individual letters have certain meaning. فَإِنْ صُحْهَا لَنَا فِيهَا عَنِ الْمَعْسُومِ شَيْءٌ قُلْنَا بِهِ. And if we get any sahih hadith from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then we can accept it regarding this meaning, regarding its meaning. وَإِلَّا. And if it is not like that or otherwise, then وَقَفْنَا حَيْثُ وَقَفْنَا. There we stop as where we are expected to stop. That is, we don't know the meaning. Then we say what? Allahu A'lam. That doesn't mean those letters have no meaning at all. Okay, then وَقُلْنَا. And we said, or we say, we must say what? آمَنَّا بِهِ كُلُّ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا. آمَنَّا بِهِ. We believed in it, in the Quran. كُلُّ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا. كُلُّ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا. All verses in the Quran are revealed from our Lord, from our Rabb, from Allah. That is, in the Quran, there are certain things which we don't know actually, or the meaning, the exact meaning, which we don't know. That is, Ummul Kitab is there, and Mutashabihat is there. Ummul Kitab, the gist of the book, or the main point. Then Mutashabihat are there. Mutashabihat, we don't know the exact meaning. There will be tafsirs, different tafsirs will be there. Then certain people will go after these Mutashabihats, and they will be going astray sometimes. Okay. Then, okay, people who believe righteously or true believers will say all verses revealed from Allah. Kullum aman nabi, kullum min indi rabbina. Aman nabi. We believed in Holy Quran, the whole Quran, and the whole verses revealed from our Lord. What we must know, we will know. Okay, if we take interest. Okay, then. Now, post 4. ولم يجمع العلماء فيها على شيء معين، وإنما اختلفوا، فمن ظهر له بعض الأقوال بدليل فعليه اتباعه، وإلا فالوقف حتى يتبين. هذا مقال. So what is our position? ولم يجمع العلماء فيها على شيء معين. علماء or scholars have not given us an actual definition or actual or a definite explanation for these letters. وإنما اختلفوا. So clearly they have gone to various points or they differ in their opinions. فمن ظهر له بعض الأقوال. So if any of the opinions are good to some persons, بدليل, with some proofs, فعليه اتباعه, then he can follow it. وإلا, otherwise, فالوقف حتى يتبين. Then he should stop there till it is cleared for him. Okay. هذا مقام. And this is our position. This search. Imam Ibn Kathir search. Now, وقال آخرون. Now some scholars search. بل إنما ذكرت هذه الحروف في أوائل السور. Suddenly, these letters have been mentioned in the beginning of certain surahs. التي ذكرت فيها. Where it is mentioned. For what purpose? لإعجاز القرآن. To explain, to denote the i'jaz or miracle of Quran. I'jaz means miracle. M-I-R-A-C-L-E. Miracle of Quran. وَأَنَّ الْخَلْقَ عَاجِزُونَ عَنْ مُعَارَضِهِ بِمِثْلِهِ. And the creations cannot bring the like of Quran. وَأَنَّ الْخَلْقَ عَاجِزُونَ. They are unable to bring the like of Quran. هذا ما أنه تركب من هذه الحروف المقطعة التي يتخاطبون بها. How? In spite of the fact that these people talk with these letters. Okay. These people talk with these letters out of which this Quran is made. Even then, people can't bring the like of Quran. The similar of Quran. Okay. That which is similar to Quran. None can bring. Okay. None can bring. Still, in spite of the fact that this Quran is made out of these words. Or made out of these letters. So to denote that, some letters are mentioned there. This is one explanation. Okay. ولهذا كل سورة افتتحت بالحروف فلا بد أن يذكر فيها الانتصار للقرآن وبيان إعجازه وعظمته. And for that, كل سورة افتتحت بالحروف. All surahs, all the 29 surahs, which began with these individual letters, follow some verses. And the following verses will be defining or explaining the i'jaz or the alamat, the nobility alamat, the i'jaz, the miracle of Quran. وَهُوَ الْوَاقِعُ فِي 29 surah. In 29 surahs, these individual letters come in the beginning. And the next sentence or ayah will be what? Regarding the miracle or nobility of Quran. Regarding the miracle or nobility of Quran. For example, Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. There, the nobility or the miracle of Quran is mentioned. About Quran is mentioned. Alif Lam Mim. Then, next. ألف لام ميم الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم نزل عليك الكتاب بالحق. There also Quran is mentioned in the next verse. Okay. Then ألف لام ميم صاد كتاب أنزل إليك. There also the كتاب القرآن is mentioned in عرف. ألف لام راء كتاب أنزلناه إليك. There also the كتاب Quran is mentioned after the individual letters. Then Surah Ibrahim. ألف لام ميم تنزيل الكتاب لا ريب فيه من رب العالمين سورة السجدة. There also كتاب اسم الشمس. Then هام ميم تنزيل من الرحمن الرحيم فصلة. There also كتاب تنزيل كتاب revelation اسم الشمس. هام ميم عين سين قاف كذلك يوحي إليك وإلى الذين من قبلك الله العزيز الرحيم عزيز الحكيم. There also وحي or revelation is mentioned. Okay, سورة شورى. وغير ذلك من الآيات الدالة التي على صحة ما ذهب إليه هؤلاء لمن أن أم عن النظر. So those who give such an explanation give the explanation like this. Okay. After mentioning the letters, they are mentioned the i'jaz or miracle of Quran. So these letters are mentioned there to explain the miracle or the nobility of Quran. Okay. Allahu a'lam. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.